So in this session, what is engineering will be mentioned, careers in engineering, areas of engineering and UTS courses, how to best prepare to study engineering at UTS, and a question and answer session at the end. If anyone has any questions, please feel free to put in the question and answer and we'll try to get back at it as soon as possible. So what is engineering? So engineering is the development of infrastructures and technologies that sustain human life and economic activity. It also exploits and extends the knowledge of mathematical and natural sciences and work with communities, clients, and consumers to design and innovate diverse systems and services. So a few examples of engineering include environmental engineering, mechanical, space, mechatronic, biomedical, data science engineering, electrical engineering, chemical engineering, civil, software, electronic, and geotechnical engineering. So the future of engineering. So a few examples is robotics, 5G, cloud engineer, software engineer, data engineering, smart manufacturing, autonomous vehicles, IoT platform development, and space exploration. So I'm going to go through the courses now for UTS engineering. So there's civil and environmental, there's software, civil structures and construction. So you can choose just civil, or you can choose to go into more of the structural side or the construction side. There's flexible, mechanical, electrical, biomedical, mechanical and mechatronics, mechatronics by itself, data science, electronic and electrical and electronic. And the newest one coming in 2023 is chemical process. So the ones with an asterisk, they're all doubles. So you can't do any combined degrees that are at the bottom. Everything else, you can combine it with a Bachelor of Business, International Studies, Creative Intelligence and Innovation, Medical Science or Science. So we're going to do a little poll. What area of engineering do you think you'd most like to study in or work in? Let's have a look. Ooh. Okay. So the most I'm seeing right now is civil and environmental, or mechanical and mechatronics, which is super normal. I think civil and mech are the biggest faculties we have. I see a few biomed, some electrical, flexible. We're going to be talking about flexible engineering soon. Some data science, and there's one or two chemical processing ones. Okay, cool. Let's move on. So flexible engineering. So we're the only engineering degree in Australia without a specified major. So why would you choose flexible engineering? You can pretty much create your own combination in a way that whatever you kind of want to learn, you can put them in and make it like a sub major. So there is sub majors in an emerging area, which is renewable energy, advanced manufacturing, and a lot more. Or you don't know which major you want to go in. So I think I did flexible my first year, and then I chose civil. And you can choose it in your second year, or you can keep going with just creating your own combination pretty much. So this is another degree that we offer, which is Bachelor of Engineering Studies. It's pretty much a technical degree which allows students to develop broad-based engineering skills, but without the full engineering status. So pretty much you learn about what engineers do and you can work with them, but you can't do like the full engineering experience pretty much. But you can major in advanced manufacturing, which you can become a technologist. You can specialize in a growing area, and it is a 3-year degree. Or you can combine it with the Master of Teaching, which is 4.5-year degree. So 1.5 years added to the Bachelor of Engineering Studies. And you can become a high school engineering studies teacher or be a specialized teacher. Okay, so the Diploma in Professional Engineering Practice, as Carmela's talked about before, you complete 2 6-month internships, one as early as your second year and the one in fourth year. So you get an opportunity to get real life industry experience before you graduate. And you can develop professional skills, which are super valuable by employers. And you build a network with top organizations in the industry. Because I do a Bachelor of Engineering and Business, I don't have the diploma with my degree. So I technically only have to do a 3-month degree. But if you guys want that 1-year experience, then you guys can add it on and that'd be a 6-year degree. So for me, I've done 3 internships kind of. My first one was I think in my third year, and I did it for a month before, and it was about like cost estimating and everything, but I did it for a month and then COVID hit, and then so I couldn't do that anymore. And then I think last year, which was my fourth year, I did a civil engineering one in membrane technology for UTS for 3 months, I think. And then now at the moment, I'm doing another internship as a civil consultant at a smaller mid-sized company called North Projects. So if anyone has any questions about internship experience and everything, I think me and Carmela both have quite a lot. So I'm going to pass it back to Carmela now to talk about a few other UTS things.
Thanks, Haley. So yeah, I think this is like a really common question that a lot of you guys will have, especially the year 12 students, because when I was in year 12, this was something that was definitely something that I really wanted to know, is about adjustment points, which I think a lot of you guys who are in year 12 right now would consider as bonus points for the university admission center when you do apply for your university courses at towards the second half of this year. So basically at UTS, we call them adjustment points, and these adjustment points are added on top of your raw ATAR that you get on the day that ATARs get released. So those adjustment points will not be shown on the day of your ATAR. These adjustment points will be added to a student's raw ATAR to give them a selection rank in total. Please note that these adjustment points does cap at 13 points at UTS. So there are numerous different ways that these adjustment points can be given out to students who are currently applying for a place at UTS for next year. So these ways can be completed through completing the UTS Engineering and IT questionnaire, good results in relevant HSC subjects, which is called the Year 12 subject scheme, your gender or even special circumstances, and even more ways to get adjustment points. So if you guys do want to learn more about adjustment points, feel free to scan the QR code on the screen right now. I'll give a couple of seconds to give you guys the opportunity to scan that code as well, or even take a picture. That will give you more information about the adjustment point schemes here at UTS. We'll just move on to the next slide, which will go through the UAC key UAC dates. So right now there is no particular dates, but this is the general calendar of events that usually happen from today. So right now at the end of April, scholarship applications are currently open. So if you guys are considering applying for any types of scholarships here at UTS, so I certainly recommend you guys to apply because you never know, you definitely might have the opportunity to be selected for those for those scholarships as well. So definitely give them a shot. Please take note that our open day this year will be on the 27th of August. Hopefully we can finally have that in person for the first time in 2 years. So definitely keep an eye out for our open day this year. And as per usual, you will have your HSC exams before you do get your HSC results, your ATARs release, and for each of the offer rounds. So there will be numerous offer rounds when you do get post your ATAR release date. So within each of these offer rounds, feel free to actually change your course selection throughout each of these rounds, but definitely make note of when the last date you can actually change your selection for each round, because you will be locked in for that particular offer round for those subject for those course selections that you definitely selected for then. But if you do have any further information, please feel free to visit the UAC website, which is the link down on the bottom of the slide there, for more information. So just moving forward, definitely was a success last year, so we're definitely bringing it back again this year. So we do have a UTS Early Entry program, and this is currently available to current domestic students or international onshore Year 12 students. So for those who are currently in Year 12 listening, definitely start thinking about whether you would like to apply. I would definitely tell you guys, definitely do apply as soon as possible, because there is different ways that you can actually apply for this early entry program. So this will be through the UTS online application portal, which is different to UAC. So there will be external links on our UTS website once this early entry program does open. And these applications will open in June, July this year and will close in September. So the result of these early entry programs will result in provisional offers, which will be released in October before your HSC commences. And the only thing that you will need to do to fulfill those provisional offers will be to complete your HSC or equivalent. Which would be, if some of you guys are in Year 12, would be your IB. If you would like to learn more information about how your points can be maximized for this early entry program, feel free to also scan the QR code on the screen right now. We also have different student support services, such as bridging courses offered in mathematics, physics, and chemistry, and what we call UPASS. So it's Peer Assisted Study Success, which is available for some of our major subjects here at UTS, especially in the Faculty of Engineering and IT. So these are just examples of some of the student support services, but there is incredibly more that you can learn on our website.